Tagus with Low and Mean, and here's a great product for your victory highball. It's our new full wrap front fender. So what makes this fender better than your stock fender? Well, one of the most noticeable things is the length that goes all the way down the tire, which is gonna completely help block road debris, block rain, you know, just keep crap from spraying and destroying or dirtying up your bike. Along with that, it just gives you that really cool low profile look that we all go for when we ride, you know, these low rider bikes. Along with that, you can see that we have a really nice form-fitting design. It's got a great front lip, really helps spray coming over the front of the bike, and we're keeping the traditional center rib that runs all the way through the design of this Victory motorcycle. This product is made from our specially formulated fiberglass construction. And you're like, oh, fiberglass, you know what? That has been long put to silence. So fiberglass these days is the highest and best and lightest material that you can possibly get. They're using it on baggers and we use it on our products. You can see we get a really nice design function and it's strong. So let me show you how to install this fender. So here's a look at the stock fender. It's short, doesn't cover the back side of the tire, which kits up a lot of debris. It's pretty high off of the tire. It's a really basic fender. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna show you how to remove it to install our fender. First step is unfortunately to take off the stock fender because the bolts are so long and they're high up towards the bead of the tire, towards this section of the tire. You gotta take off the wheel and tire. So you wanna make sure that your motorcycle is stable. It's on a jack, it's not gonna fall over. You wanna make sure that when you take off the front wheel, the bike doesn't fall forward. So make sure the bike is balanced, stable, strapped down. Take extra precaution. You don't want your baby to fall over. So we're gonna remove the front wheel. Then we're gonna be able to get to the fender bolts. We're gonna remove the fender and the fender bolts. And then at that time, we can install the new Low and Mean fender for the Victory. You loosen up these two bolts. Use the supplied makeshift tool. Put it in there. You'll use your wrench to break that loose.
Once you have the axle nut off, it's time to unloosen the axle pinch bolts on the other side of the tire. Then go ahead and remove the axle.
The axle comes out smoother when there's very little pressure on the tire. Right. The tire is not off the ground, but it's not. There's not a lot of pressure on it, so the axle will slide out real easy.
Then it's time to gently slide the tire out the front.
There's two collars. This side is the thicker one. The other side, the exhaust side of the bike, has a thinner one. These two bolts here on each side need to be removed. This is a 13 millimeter socket.
As you take the last two bolts out, make sure you're holding onto the fender so it doesn't fall to the ground. The Low and Mean kit includes the fender, a tube of Loctite, four bolts, and four rubber washers, along with a special tool to take the nut off the axle.
So why do we offer you hardware when the bike already comes with it? Well, you'll slightly notice that our bolt is a little bit shorter, and we did this so when the wheel is on, that you can still take out the bolt and remove the fender if you need to put the bike on a jack or whatever the situation is. You have that option without having to remove the front wheel. So we offer these bolts, rubber washer, and Loctite to secure it all down.
Before installing the Low and Mean fender, put some Loctite in all four holes. It's always a good idea to use Loctite on everything you do. The bolt goes through the fender, then the rubber washer goes between the fender and the fork. You'll want to take the first one and get it lined in and just tighten up with your fingers, and then go across to the other side and do the top one on that side, then go back and do the two bottom bolts. Once you have all four bolts started, finger tight them down, alternating back and forth, so you're sort of keeping the fender lined up in the center at all times. Now it's time to slide the tire back in. Remember to replace the two collars that you took off when you slid the tire out. Gently slide the tire in between the forks. May take a little wiggling right at the end to get it all lined up nice and perfect. When you get it there, take the axle and push it back through. You may have to tap it a little bit with a rubber hammer to get it all the way through. Once the axle is pushed through, it's time to tighten down the pinch bolts on the other side of the front tire. Make sure you always use Loctite. And then it's time to put the axle nut back on with the tool provided by Low and Mean. Now it's time to tighten the pinch bolts on this side of your front wheel.
Aligning the fender with the tire. So when it's time to align the fender, it's something you should understand is when I tighten the left side, it pulls on the right side. When I tighten the right side, it pulls on the left side. So when you tighten down a bolt, you kind of want to stare at the bottom side of the fender and watch the gap between the fender and the tire. So I'm going to start off with the left side bottom, and you can see it moving a little bit. So I'll go over to the right side bottom and so forth. So you want to evenly tighten down the bolts so the fender is perfectly aligned.
Once you have the fender in place and all the bolts tightened down, don't forget to reinflate your front tire.
So that's pretty much it for installing this fender. Now, if you go to remove the fender, our suggestion is to deflate the tire. The tire will kind of suck in just a little bit so you can get up here and remove these bolts. So you can see the finish on the fender is not matched to the bike. So you might be pulling off the fender to take it to your painter, whatever the case is. Now you know. So the longer fender, the design follows the wheel. I think the fender complements this Victory motorcycle. So please hit subscribe, follow us on Facebook, and join us at lowandmean.com.